again, but it's really beautiful to see everyone out here tonight. We're part of thousands of people across the country who are demonstrating tonight to say that we won't accept police brutality in communities and our cities anymore. To say that Black Lives Matter.
Worse yet, if you go go down and ask for the security camera tape that supposedly caught this scene, that supposedly backs up everything the police say, that supposedly justifies shooting this man 5 bullets and 6 wounds, one in the back, you will be told you can't see that because it's part of an ongoing investigation. All right, now what are we investigating here? A homicide, right? All right, who's the suspect here? Officer Antonio Hudson, right? We got an open investigation. You, the public, you can't see the evidence that your own money pays for. We got an ongoing investigation, but guess what? The suspect is back in his patrol car, fully armed, patrolling the same beat.
We can kill you.
Now, what kind of investigation is that? That is a phony investigation. The DA and the grand jury haven't even looked at this case yet. Now, this is what we're up against. The previous one I mentioned, Jason Harrison, the two officers that shot him, when the family of Jason Harrison tries to get the lapel camera of the officer that shot their relative, they're told they can't get it. Why? It's an ongoing investigation. You go to the DA, if you investigate, you finish your investigation? No. Grand jury ruled on this? No. So it's an ongoing investigation of a homicide. We got two suspects. We know their names. We know where they work. We know the car they're driving around in. Except one thing we don't know is how to take these killer cops off the street. This is what we're up against. Approximately every 2 months, an unarmed man is shot by the Dallas police over the past 14 years. And if you add in people who they say are armed, like a guy that got killed the same day that Andrew Gunner got killed, had a knife, holding a knife, a Latino kid, he was shot 5 times to death. The officer sees he has a knife. Does he back up? Does he start talking? Does he ask for help? No. He says drop the knife and opens fire, and the young man's dead. This was one day after Michael Brown was shot. Now, there was a third incident that Monday. An old white guy, older than me, was in North Dallas on Frankfort Road. He's firing an automatic rifle at firemen. He's firing an automatic rifle at the police who respond to the call. This man is so insane, he thinks he's setting up the Kingdom of Dagestan. That's his name. Do the police call in a sharpshooter team and take him out? Do the guns go around and say, hey, drop it or we'll shoot, and then shoot him 5 times, once in the back? No, they talk him down. They do what you're supposed to do when you're faced with a mentally ill person acting in an aberrant manner. They talk him down because why? They valued that life. They didn't know which rich family that nut belonged to, so they had to value his life. And until we get a culture that values all of our lives, we're going to be fighting this fight. But I'm not saying that to say, yeah, rah-rah, let's keep going. I'm saying that to say this. The facts are on our side. Reality is on our side. This house of cards, this a pack of lies will crumble. But it takes a sustained effort on the part of us and all of our friends and neighbors that aren't here. And all those people on Facebook, too, your friends. You know, we got to get them, too. Thanks a lot. Thanks for coming. Keep up the fight.
Mothers Against Police Brutality, if you haven't heard of them, they're amazing. And the founder started it after her son was murdered. And that officer is back on the street 3 days later. As a result of their work, cops are off the street longer, which is amazing. And they're still fighting every day in Dallas. So get involved if you don't have something you're already working on. All right. So our next speaker is Kel Spryman. She's in the International Socialist Organization out in Denton. She's worked on anti-racist work to end the death penalty, which is the new lynching in America for black people. There are just as many people killed on death row and by cops as there were lynchings back in the day. It's racist, and it needs to be over. So, actually more. Fantastic. And Elle is over there. Hey, love. Give it up for Kel.
I didn't want to set the siren off.
I didn't want